Hello everybody, my name is Megan and I'm glad you clicked on my sub vlog today. I'm reaching the end of my experience here and I hope you enjoy my last week as a long-term sub in fourth grade. Happy Monday. I am in comfy clothes today and I have my robe because today was pajama slash comfy day. And surprisingly, I was one of the only teachers that participated, which, I don't know, to me that's very surprising because if I have any excuse to wear things that are other than what they want me to wear, I guess, I don't know, if I can be comfy, I'm totally going to do it. I don't know why other teachers didn't choose to participate, but I really, really enjoyed wearing slippers and a robe and just having a lot of fun with the kids and just enjoying my time. So let's see what's going on this week. This weekend was Mother's Day, so that was really fun, but this week, since it is my last week, I'm sorry, this is really annoying me. Since it is my last week, we're starting a new unit, so that kind of helps things like transition a little bit, and I'm just trying to have some fun with the kids. So we are moving into, now this is a, sorry, there's a lot going on around me right now. Anyways, so we're moving into a unit, and this is the district's decision, or like unit plan. So it is about E.B. Lewis, and he's an illustrator, if you don't know that. And he's illustrated a lot of really amazing books. A lot of them are very diverse, and it's just really cool to read about them. So today we read This Little Light of Mine, and I actually just covered up the words, and we just really talked about the pictures, and what do we see, and what kind of story do the pictures tell. And then we uncovered the words and kind of talked about that. And our leading question throughout the whole unit really is how do the illustrations help us understand the story better, or how do the illustrations help us understand the story? So we have a couple. These are the books that I'm going to read, but the district also provides many other selection of books as well. But these are ones I'm reading. This is one that I recognized right away that I've read a couple times in different classes in this district. It's called The Other Side. And again, you're gonna see all the illustrations are by E.B. Lewis. So yeah, that one is, I'm excited to read that one to this class. Each Kindness, such an important, important thing to talk about in classrooms and is really a big thing nowadays, or more so in schools, is that choosing kindness and being kind and everything like that. I wanted to choose one that also reflected like some girls, and I don't know, so it says I love my hair. And then this one, I couldn't help it, I love dogs so much. And this is actually from the perspective of the dog, and he kind of gets captured and I guess he's going to get rescued. So I'm really excited. Those are the selections that I chose for this week, and I'm really excited. I think the kids are going to have some fun with it, and I think it'll be awesome. For our math today, we did this thing called Fraction Avenue. I think you can look it up. I should put it over here. And basically, it's kind of one of those like guided drawings, except for it has fractions in it. So here you can see the different things, and there's even a bonus to kind of extend it. I just read it to the whole class and showed it under the document camera, that way kids could follow along and they wouldn't, like if they got behind, they could catch up. And so this is just kind of what mine, or this example looks like. But the kids really had fun with it. It was kind of hard to keep them quiet because they were kind of confused. Like some of them were confused about the equivalent fractions. So the first thing is you draw 8 houses, and then you'd have to go through the different steps, and you have to convert some of these fractions or find the equivalent fraction in eighths, and some of my students just aren't there yet. So for some of them that was really tough, but Overall, it was just a really good activity that was just kind of fun. My last note for today, and for anybody who's a long-term sub, big advice is when you get to the end of your long-term sub experience, make sure everything's kind of ready for that other teacher to come back. I know that's kind of obvious, but just something I wanted to put out there for you guys. So I have a couple of major things and then some minor things that I'm trying to make sure, like I have a to-do list that I'm going to make sure that I go through this week. So you can see this map is down. Don't know how to get it back up. And that's going to be one of my things in my to-do list. So I just made this list and it says before my long-term sub is over. So I just have a couple different things like clearing the computer off, making sure my information is off of there, and any information or like lessons or anything that I want to keep, I'm putting into my Google Drive. I want to remind the principal here that she said she'd write me a letter of recommendation after observing me for 3 days. So I just want to remind her about that. I'm going to wait until probably Friday if she hasn't sent anything to just be like, hey, it's my last day. Wondering if you're still going to send the letter of recommendation, things like that. Of course, cleaning off the desk is major, making sure all my stuff is brought home. I kind of did that on Friday already, but just to make sure all that's brought home, having the students kind of clear and organize their bins just so it's fresh and new for when she comes back for the last few weeks. Organizing the cart, so, oh, you can't see it, but there's a little cart like on the other, like over here, and just to go through and organize that. I have some things on there as well, so doing that. I have a couple things that I need to return, like library books that I checked out under the teacher's name. I want to do a small gift for the kids, probably just some pencils or something easy that they can use in school. Wipe down everything, take home all my things. Students to wipe down their desks, erasing or like rewriting things on the boards. Again, so just that it's like fresh and new and everything like that. Oh, I wrote organizing desk on here twice because I guess I really, really want to make sure I do that. Making a card for this teacher. Sharpening pencils, different things like that. So, anywho, that is my goal this week. I can't believe it's the last week. It blows my mind and it's crazy. So, I'm going to go home and I will talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye. Hi everybody. Happy Tuesday. Today is hat day. I have my most favorite hat, my Eddie Bauer hat. And hello everybody. Happy Tuesday. Today is hat day, so I have my favorite Eddie Bauer hat on. And so far this morning has been kind of tough. Luckily we had library this morning, so we have our morning meeting early and then we go to library. And it was just tough because it's one thing for kids to blurt out or not do what they're supposed to be doing, and it's another for them to kind of talk back when I ask them to stop doing something. So I got really frustrated. I talked to these two kids and they just mouthed off to me, and I was really frustrated. And you know, I try to have private conversations and they're just like not being very respectful. And anywho, I just told myself to take a deep breath, it's fine. And the only way to solve this would be to take a step back and just like talk to them respectfully and kind and just try to come to a compromise and put out my expectations and explain to them exactly what I expect. And if they can't do that, then, you know, they're gonna go somewhere else to do their work. So that's what I did. I think it really helped. Yesterday it really helped to just take a step back and do the same thing. And you know, the one student that I especially talked to straightened up for the rest of the day. So I'm hopeful that the same will happen today. It's just really hard sometimes, and so anyways, so I have just a few more days here, and I just wanted to show you guys kind of what it looks like when I write a morning message. So I'm just going to write my Friday message. I already wrote Tuesday today, which was this morning, Wednesday, and Thursday. So I just need to write Friday, and I don't really have much planning to do, so it'll be kind of an easy week. I would like some cards from the kids, but I don't really know how to ask for that without being kind of weird about it. So for my Friday message, I'm just going to ask the kids what their favorite moment with me was. So yeah, anyways, I'm going to show you guys that, and not too much else going on right now. So you can see this is the morning message that I did for today. My next one tomorrow is, and I don't know if you can see me, so I'll just kneel down here, but is talking about watercolor. So I just gave a little bit of history on watercolor, and then I said, what scene from your book report are you going to paint? Because they're going to do a watercolor picture of their painting, since we're talking about illustrators. And this particular illustrator, Evie Lewis, uses watercolors. So I just gave a little bit of history on that. Then Thursday, I just gave a little bit of history on illustrations themselves, and just a little tally chart of if you enjoy picture books or chapter books more. And Friday, I'm just going to do it in red. So I always start out with the date. Friday, 5/18/18. And then I usually do some kind of greeting. I think I'll just do Happy Friday. And I'm just going to put an alliteration in there. Fabulous. Fourth graders. Whoops. And then this is just going to be kind of my last day. So I'm just going to make it kind of fun. Really enjoyed trying to think of what to write. you could kind of see my message there. Otherwise, hey, my head was probably cut off, so lovely. So I always like to give real world examples when I explain things. So I just showed the kids some different architectural buildings that are really, really cool and amazing. And then I also Googled CAD design. And that's what I looked up, CAD architectural drawings. And I just wanted to show them a little bit about CAD and kind of what an architect does, because I think it's really cool. And then I'm just going to look up an episode of Fixer Upper, because I know they have little scenes where they show the kind of CAD design look. I'm just gonna see if I can find maybe a video or something to just show that part. I don't need to have the whole thing. I just want to show the part where they explain how they are going to show the house and stuff. So I might need to look up a full episode and just find that part. But I'm hopeful that I can find one and get it up there so that the kids can see kind of what that CAD or like design part looks like in terms of building a house, because we are doing the Geo Metro City, so I wanted to talk more about architecture and things like that and building a city and stuff. So this is my plan, to just show them a little clip of the example, but I'll have to go through a lot of this episode to get to that point. So here we go. That's what I'm going to spend my prep doing.
No.
I just wanted to show you guys. This was from Friday, one of those kind of like direction quizzes. You guys can find those online. I just searched up direction quiz and kind of made my own. And as you can see, not very many followed. I just covered up the names here just to, you know, protect my students, but and not embarrass them as well. So yeah, I just thought that would be interesting to show you guys kind of how that went. And yeah, it's kind of fun to test that with your students and see if they're actually following directions, because it says read all directions very carefully. And I said also step one is read all steps before doing anything, and they didn't follow. Some didn't follow either one. They were confused because they are supposed to answer this bottom question usually, but I did tell them don't answer the question below, so it was a little bit confusing. But yeah, I just thought that'd be fun to update you guys on that. So see you guys tomorrow.
Happy Thursday, everybody. It's been a crazy week, but it's been really good, and I can't believe tomorrow is my last day. It's just blows my mind that, you know, it went so quickly. And I'm sad, but I'm also excited for kind of what is to come next. The other thing is today, by the way, it's the end of the day, I bought some M&M's, and I'm kind of just surviving off of M&M's today. The kids are just really, I think they're kind of sad to see me go, and I don't know, it's a very bittersweet feeling, but they've been a little bit crazy, so we're kind of surviving on M&M's to get us through the day. We also had kind of a peanut scare. It wasn't because of the M&M's. A student brought in a snack with peanuts in it, and one of our students is allergic, and he could just smell it in the air and just was feeling nauseous. So I sent him to the nurse, and he was okay the rest of the day. I kind of just tied up the bag and put it to the side, and I think once the smell kind of left the room, then he was fine the rest of the day, so that's good. Otherwise, yeah, this week has been kind of short because it just went by so fast, and again, I just can't believe that it's already over. Like, this is it. I just wanted to show you guys quick. Most of the kids were finishing up their Geo Metro City. They have to finish it up tomorrow, but this was kind of how one of them turned out. So these are kind of some 3D models of it. And some of them worked really hard, and I'm really, really proud of them. So yeah, it was a good day today, and I can't wait to see kind of what tomorrow brings. So I hope you guys enjoyed. I'm gonna do tomorrow as a separate video. So I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you guys tomorrow, but for you guys it'll probably be a couple of days. So I hope you guys enjoy, and I will see you next time. Bye.